So here I am, standing before you with a shape that doesn't fit in the hourglass. Unattractive, imperfect, and drab. Debilitated with lectures on BMI, I constantly being diagnosed as oversized. With an humdrum existence and frantic attempts to fit into this world, I screamed inside the locked doors until I passed on like a hacking floor. I masked my face with matte products that tempt only to satisfy the cravings that your eyes intend. Result, I started radiating disinterest. I changed my wardrobe and wore kurtas that were sleeved, and at night, the note apps read the taunts I received. Again and again, I bayed at myself for being oversized and for the stretch marks winding up my thighs. I pleaded, I cried, I tried to fit into this world, only to be chastised with dazed alliance. Let's end this drama and get it straight. I said to myself, stepping out the cage, it's time to end this inordinate shame with vehemence and strength. And no matter what, these trolls, tweets, or memes, I'll reach out to each one of you as tales often do. Because I am not a trophy for this heedless world. I'm not a trophy for this heedless world. I'm an amaranthine with heart, blood, and adipocytes. And I refuse to ingest myself with the crown of shame. I refuse to ingest myself with the crown of shame. And no matter what, I have to set this flame. After all, my heart has no bone to shatter. After all, my heart has no bone to shatter. It will keep beating just the same. It will keep beating just the same. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Queen Sarkar, and today I'm going to talk about self-love. Because for today's generation, the concept of self-love is an overblown theory, and we often tend to ignore it. People aspire to be perfect, and perfectionism is considered to be a greater attribute than loving your own self. Now, I'm not going to blame anyone for this, because the modern society is shaped in such a way that we are sort of constantly bound to compete against each other or with ourselves. We push ourselves too hard in order to meet the expectations that the society has kept for us. And this is where we go wrong. The poem that I have just recited somehow encapsulates my journey towards self-love. I still remember composing this poem back in 2019 when I was invited for one of the international poets' meet. And I remember once I finished the poem, and when I was, you know, coming down of the days, a lady came running to me and she literally hugged me with teary eyes. And for a moment I was like, what's happening? And I remember she was repeating 2-3 lines again and again, and she was saying, this is me, this is me. I felt like you're reading about me. And that was the moment when I realized that how important it is for all of us to express ourselves the way we are and not trying to be what the society wants us to be. The lady was suffering from some hormonal issues, and that's why she was gaining weight. And my poem, Oversized, somehow talks about that problem when the society keeps on questioning you about how you look and how you should look. In an age of virtual reality, when we are constantly being scrutinized for what we are, how we should look, how we should talk, what we should post, what we should not post, what should be the video's length and all those things, it's very important to understand your own worth. It's very important to know how you feel about your own self rather than how the society is thinking about you. And that's why self-love is very important. Now, when I say self-love, I don't mean that you need to be selfish. I don't mean that you need to be overconfident. I don't mean that you have to create a border between yourself and the society. What I mean is you need not be too much harsh on yourself. What I mean is you need not be too much tough on yourself. You need to understand that not every day you would get success. Not every day would be like the day you have ever wanted. But in all those days when things are not going the way you want to be, you need to be with yourself. You need to be your own strength. And that's why self-love becomes the key to happiness. Thank you.